नमस्ते टू ऑल जयवंत स्टूडेंट। आई एम जयवंत राजेंद्र चौधरी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। टुडे वी आर कवर द न्यू सेशंस एंड न्यू सेशंस नेम इज अरे इन जावा। बेसिकली अरे इज अ कॉमन फीचर्स ऑफ ऑल मैक्सिमम प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज लाइक सी, सी प्लस प्लस, पाइथन एंड जावा, एसपीडॉट, सी शार्प। बट वी टॉक अबाउट जावा, जावा हैव सम एक्स्ट्रा फीचर्स to use a array, and now we start what is the array in Java. Basically array are used to store multiple value in a single variable instead of declaring separate variable for each value, and we can say that array is a similar collections of similar data type that store same type of data, we are called array. Basically in unlike C and C++, we can say that array is a user defined data type, but in case of Java have a object and that object name is array. We can say that array is a object in Java. Okay, now let's start the definitions of arrays. Normally an array is a collection of similar types of elements which have a continuous memory location. Okay, continuous memory location means every data element is stored at the continuous memory pattern in Java. Java is an object which contains element of an array data type. Additionally, the element of an array are stored in a continuous memory location, and each data element is stored at a particular address, and that address is called indexing. Means array have some index for use to for store the data element, like first data element in array is stored on index 0, and the last data element stored in array is stored the locations of n minus 1 index. Suppose you have 10 data element, then the indexing range from 0 to n minus 1 means 10 minus 1 and 0 to 9. Array in Java is indexed where the first element of the array is stored at the 0 index, and second element is stored at the first index, and so on. Unlike C, C++, we can get the length of the array using the length memory, but in C, C++, we need to use the size of operator. But Java does not have any size of operator to find the length of an array. In Java, array is the object of a dynamically generated classes. Java array inherits the object class. Basically, Java, in Java, in case of Java, array is the object, so that this array inherits the object class. The implement and serializable as well as clonable interface, we can store primitive value. In Java, array stores primitive value or object in array. The Java provides the features of anonymous array, which is not available in C and C++. And here we describe some advantage and disadvantage of array in Java. Firstly, code optimization. It makes the code optimized. We can retrieve or store the data efficiently. And secondly, the random access. We can get any data located at index, because array in Java, each data element are stored at the positions of index. And some disadvantage of array in Java. Firstly, size limit. We can store only the fixed size of element in array. It does not grow its size at some time. So to solve this problem, collections framework is used in Java, which grows automatically. The extra features in Java name each collection, that is store the multiple data types, multiple data element, different type of element that cover the size problem of array. Here are some images, and this image describes the length of array. Here we store 10 data element in this array, and first data element is stored on 0 index, and last data element is stored 9 index. there are disturbed type of array. There are two type of array in Java. Firstly, single dimensions array, and second is multi dimensions array. Single dimensions array in Java syntax. Here we describe the syntax of how to declare a single dimensions array. There are firstly we declare data type, second is subscript and array name. And you also declare this pattern data type space subscript and array. You also declare third method data type array name and subscript. There are different pattern to declare a array in Java. Okay. Here we declare a single dimensions array in Java. Array name, variable name, and new data type and type. Okay, let's we take an example how to declare an array in Java. Firstly, we take a class test array and mention the main method and data type int. A is array name subscript. New keyword is used to allocate the runtime memory looking for a object A. And int subscript 5. 5 is a represent to size limit of array. Means the upper limit of this size to store maximum 5 value, 5 data elements in this array. Firstly, first data element 10 and 10 value stored on the index 0. Second 20, 20 stored 0, 1 index. And last data element 50, 50 is stored on index array, index in array index 4. Okay, here we put the single statement for loop that calculate this data element and print on our console. Okay, declarations, instantiations, and initializations of the Java array. How to declare a Java array? Here we discuss how to declare a Java array. We can declare and initialize the Java array together by that. Int A is array name, and this array holds four types of data element 33, 3, 4, and 5. This is a pattern of how to declare an array in Java. And let's we take an example how to initialize of Java array in single line. Okay. Firstly, we take a class name. Class name is just array 1, and here we mention the main method. Main method that hold some statement in the data type to represent the type of a data stored is array name, and this is a data element to store in this object, array object, and the print the value on our console. This is a for loop to calculate the length of your data your array, and here we print the data element value. And second phase, second method for each loop for Java. Basically, for each loop work as the same for simple for loop, but this is different, some different between for and for each loop. And here we let's take an example using for each loop. We can also print the Java array using for each loop. The Java for each loop print the array element by one. So it holds an array element in a variable, then execute the body of the loop. For each loop, execute the all functionality in a single element, that all calculations are stored in single variable, and after print the value. There are syntax of how to declare a for each loop. Firstly, we write the for data type and variable name, colon, and array. Each of data element in stored in array that holds this type of variable. Okay, let's we take an example of this pattern for each loop. Firstly, we take a class name test array 1, mention the main method, and here to declare an array simple. And this array is stored 4 type of value, 33, 3, 4, and 5. And this value execute by for each loop for int I array. And each data element stored in array are hold on I. And finally, we print the I value on the console. Passing array to a method in Java. How to pass a array to a method in Java? we can pass the Java array to method so that we can reuse the same logic on any array. Let's take a simple example to get the minimum number of an array. Here we take, let's we take example of this pattern, test class name test array 2, main method mention, and here we take a method, and this method is declared as a static method. This method is called static method. Static method means whenever a object allocate a object memory, then automatically call this statement, this static method. And int main equals to array 0 means array 0 is declared as minimum, and here we calculate the length of array, conditions, put the conditions is min greater than array I and min equals to array I, and print the value of minimum. Here we put the main method, and this main method is declare the array and hold the some value and call the min method and pass a value here. Okay, and finally the result of this program is 3. Okay, thank you.